morning to all present here. It's my great pleasure and privilege to welcome you all for this great occasion. Now our guest is here. I would like to welcome our guest, Dr. Nityanand Devaraj, Executive Director, MX Reliance and Chairman, Sri Avinashi Appar Trust. He has more than 3 decades of experience in engineering manufacturing organizations, from hard manufacturing and marketing to general management as business head, working for PI Group, LMW Group, LG Group, Suzlon Energy, L&T, Hitachi and CRA Group. He played a wider role in turning around the division at a company and in establishing large-scale projects as benchmarks in industry. He is a managing trustee of a family-managed trust involved in activities like rendering food, shelter, education and Medicare for underprivileged. Noted for rendering services during Chennai, Kerala, Tanjore and Nilpuri during Perth. I'm happy to extend a warm welcome to you, sir.
Thank you, Dr. Valanpati, for the wonderful introduction.
Thank you, sir. I would like to welcome our respected CEO, Dr. Gunasegaran, faculty members and non-teaching staffs. Dear students, WIMS believes in a system of education which is student-centric. Being the principal stakeholders in higher education, students are provided ample opportunity to design and execute the curricular and co-curricular activities. WIMS is a leading B-school approved by AECTE in Delhi and affiliated to Anna University Chennai, with an avowed goal of achieving human excellence by means of academic and allied programs. WIMS proposes to offer an ample, unique learning experience to its students by means of 2 prolonged strategies. Spreading the net wide to garner a variety of learning resources such as e-journals, digital library, virtual learning, tapping global intellectual infrastructure, anchoring on experiential learning relevant to the Indian environment, capturing the real-time experience so that learning is meaningful to close the ground realities. A variety of methods are used to teach students. Lecture sessions are supplemented with case studies, EML program, documentary program, teamwork, assignment, seminar presentations, business games, etc. Considerable emphasis is placed on team assignments, team discussions, and teamwork. One of the best ways to learn about college is to experience it, talk to people who are currently there and here, and see what they think. It's the most remarkable 2 years of your life, and you will never get it back. I'm delighted to welcome all of your new students to WIMS Coimbatore 2, and glad that you have chosen to study at this institute. We wish you much success as you fulfill your academic goals and as you learn more about yourself and place in the world. Once again, I welcome you all for this great occasion. Thank you.
Introduction of the chief guest, today's chief guest. I'm privileged to introduce Dr. Nityanand Devaraj, sir, the executive director, MX Alloys, and the chairman of Sri Avinashi Appan Trust. So I would say that I am introducing a complete man as provided excellence in all the fields whichever that he has touched. So we find a rare professional having great achievements in both academic side as well as in the industrial side. In the academic side, he has achieved a B mechanical. He has completed B mechanical with distinction, MBA with the gold medalist, and he is a university topper. He is representing many governing councils of many top business schools, and he has framed the syllabus for some of the courses like operations management and others. For the academic side, he has been contributing a lot. On the other side, if you take the industry side, he has about 3.5 decades of experience. From grassroots to the top level, he has achieved great things, and he has been awarded with many awards in the field of industry, like Indian Foundry of the Year, Young Foundry Man and the Foundry Award, Foundry Man Award, Green Award and the Safety Award from Tamil Nadu government, and at national level from IIF, the first Indian foundry in the segment to get OHSAS 18001 and ISO 5001 awards, which is very, very difficult to achieve it. And he, I mean, apart from MBAs, completed his PhD in management, I'm sorry. And he has done a lot in the industry side. Apart from that, he is well known for the third segment, that is service. As a good human, he is running a family managed trust through which he has been rendering to the underprivileged people in terms of providing food, shelter and education, and his services are remarkable during the floods in different places like Chennai, Kerala and other places. So I am very happy to introduce such a great personality to address us here in this inaugural address. Welcome you, sir.
Thank you so much, sir, for the wonderful introduction and the time given. Should I start now?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, okay. Friends, I mean, request all others to put the mic on mute. Probably Dr. Valarmuri can keep her open so that I can understand if things are being heard properly.
Sure.
Yeah, yeah. All others can go on mute, except Dr. Valarmuri.
Sharing, sir, sharing. Yeah.
Shall we? Yeah. Friends, very good morning both to faculty and the students. It's always a privilege and honor to address the budding professionals, especially the management graduates. People are known MBA as Management Master of Business Administration. I normally call MBA as Management by Application. This is a course which is a common course irrespective of what your undergraduate course you have undergone. And obviously the career options are manifold for people who are coming out of the management course. And unless you enjoy learning it, again I'm repeating, it cannot be taught, it has to be learned. Unless you enjoy learning it, you will not really imbibe the qualities of management principles, which is more than as a professional, it will be helpful for human beings in your life. I have always felt management education has made people as better human beings than mere professionals. Of course, professional is the outcome. Obviously, the byproduct of that is becoming a good human being. There is no principle I have ever come across in my life which hasn't been useful in my personal life and both in professional career as well. Having said that, what do we expect as industrialists from the budding professionals, management graduates? Obviously, it is the ABCD for any graduate or any professional coming into the organization. We look first and foremost to the attitude. Irrespective of the marks you have scored, obviously marks are important because that gives us an indication of how serious you are in studies. And when you are serious in studies, we also believe you will be serious as a professional too. So attitude is very, very important. Second is behavior. We start observing the behavior as a student, and the moment you get into the organization, right from your induction to the security process, the way you behave with our receptionist, the way you behave during the interview. So all these things may appear simple, but they are very important for your professional career and life. C is conviction and commitment to the profession. It's another reason why I say marks is important, because you should have conviction in your studies, and if you have conviction in your studies, you will not naturally commit to the studies, and that will reflect in your academic performance. As you excel in your academic performance, we strongly believe you will also excel in your professional performance. D is discipline. This one thing which separates Indians from the rest of the world is discipline. We have always been told what we are supposed to do. Many a times we are not told where what we are not supposed to do. That is one thing which we have to learn ourselves. Looking at the ambience, looking at the environment, observing what happens around us, it's important for us to understand what we should not do. The difference between a good professional and an average professional is the focus and the commitment to things what we should do, and obviously moving away from things what we should not do. Given the current scenario, the new normal in which we are operating, quite naturally, the focus is on things which we should not do. Let me go to the topic what I'm supposed to speak on today. Can you go to the first slide, doctor? You've already gone to the second slide. Can you share the first slide, please? Am I audible?
Yes, sir.
See, but the topic what I've chosen is management preparing for the new normal. You know, the kind of new normal what we are going through. Thanks to the disruption caused by the pandemic, which has not been foreseen at all by any of the nations, irrespective of what technology levels they are in. This kind of disruption as unanticipated in the VUCA world, volatile, uncertain, complex and ambiguous world, it further creates disturbance in the minds of people more than in the businesses. I have always felt every disruption is an opportunity for business professionals to look at alternatives and grow faster than what they used to grow. Having said that, here the A stands for agility. As long as you have your agile and build an organization which is completely agile, the time taken to change, realize the change and change is very short. Having spoken about agile organizations, it is possible only when the professionals are also agile. Ability to adapt to the changes is very important here. Can you go to the next slide, please? So the basic this is always, you know, 3 P's: product management, people management, and process management. That's where the management professional come in. Actually, the interfaces, you have stakeholders at one end, you have products, people, and process another end. It's a technology that interfaces between the stakeholder expectations and the 3 P's management. Obviously, you are looking at product and services management, technology management, and delivery management. Delivery management involves QA, quality, cost. Obviously, the quantity, logistics, and how you manage the entire process, QCDL. Next slide, please. In the bottom of every slide, I have captured the 5 M's, which is the founding principle of the management education: man, machine, material, methods, and of course, money. As long as we observe and analyze all the 5 M's in a proper way, that's what the management education gives you to understand. So if you can have a control on these 5 M's, what, why, where, when, how, and how much, each of these 5 M's, this 4 W's and 2 H's have to be employed. And if you can do it meticulously, you can now understand why I said MBA education helps you to be a better human being than just a mere professional. Start applying these things in your day-to-day life. Your progress is only going to be forward and never backward. Significant changes in the practice of management as a profession in the new millennium. Constraints imposed by environment considerations. Thanks to COVID, new regulatory requirements are coming. People have started questioning the existing regulation, whether it is sufficient. Sufficiency tests have been employed, and I'm sure you will agree with me, going forward, it's going to be not easier. So obviously, discipline is again going to be more important, not only in conducting ourselves, but the way we conduct businesses also. Customization demanded by diverse customers. Thanks to the Almighty, we have all been created as unique human beings. Having said that, each one of us have our own unique expectations. In a mass world, we need to make products that will meet these unique expectations of every individual in the marketplace. That's both a challenge and opportunity. I look at it as an opportunity. Opportunity is offered by technology developments in several sectors. Look at IoT today. People are talking about IoT across all sectors: medical, transport, manufacturing, garment sector. One of the questions during a session in the Krishna Mall, one of the students asked, "Sir, how do you foresee the future of garment industry?" So we have seen ready-made garments. We have seen only the cloths being manufactured, go to the tailor hood and start making garments. It's only a question of time where over the mobile phone we can capture our image, and you can still order for a custom-made, mass-produced product. That's the way it is going to happen. Availability of sophisticated diagnostic and computational tools. Thanks to the kind of advancement what we have got, not only in the medical field, but also in the management field, especially the sensors, both touch and non-touch, it has helped us, RFPs, it has helped us to manage the process in a value-added way and move the human beings out of the mundane process like counting and checking. So these will help to improve the human productivity in manifold times. wide choice of products and services. As the world magnifies, the product life cycle goes down drastically. Obviously, people will look for challenges, also opportunities. And as consumers, we look at choices. The product life cycle has today come down to less than 3 years, which originally was more than 5 years. So you can imagine the focus that is required on our own processes, which will help us to design products, cannibalize our own products, and look at newer products for the newer markets. Implications of globalization, innovation as the basis of competitiveness. The difference between China and us, the only thing we can bring in is the differentiation. People differentiation, process differentiation, and product differentiation. If you look at competing with China in terms of technology and mass production, we will stand nowhere in front of them. Because the kind of money power they have and the kind of commitment towards the process what they have, it's beyond imagination. It's a communist country which is working in a dictatorial way. And naturally, as a democratic country, we have our own deficiencies to compete with such an economy. Next slide, please. Man, machine, material, money and methods, as I said at the beginning, decision influencer is the technology. The rate at which we adopt technology, rate at which we change our own self delivering the products and services, technology is the major influencer. When I say technology, the only one caution I would like to give here is we need to look at appropriate technology and not mere technology. Automation for the sake of automation in a country like ours will not work and yield the expected employment generation. Unless otherwise we are committed to employment generation, the market will not grow. It's both our necessity and need. We create employment and make more and more people earn to buy our products and services. Next slide, please. See, you have heard about the word both efficient and effective. I'm sure you will know the difference between efficiency and effectiveness. Efficiency is nothing but doing things in a very efficient way, whereas effectiveness is doing right things. Here, the lean management should be the core strategy to support growth and profitability. Waste has to be eliminated from anywhere and everywhere. Good management is all about doing only things those customers are willing to pay for. This is very, very important. You need to understand everything what we do and every process what we adopt should result in value addition to the customer. Value addition can offer only in two forms. Either you increase the performance of the product or reduce the cost of the product. These are the two things which can happen in terms of the customer expectation. What are the kind of waste we should eliminate? Overproduction, waiting time, transportation, unwanted process, unwanted WIP, unwanted efforts, and unwanted defects. WIP is nothing but working process, which is a major cost for many of the industries. Look at the garment industry, look at the automotive industry, look at the kind of stocks that what they have in the retail and the dealer outlets. It's unimaginable, and we are supposed to pay for all those things. A garment which is manufactured for 100 rupees, when it comes to the retail, it's sold for 1000 rupees. The 900 rupees is going for non-value added waste. Those are the ways that are being captured here. It might be surprising, but it's a fact what I'm saying. Garment which is manufactured for 100 rupees at cost is sold for minimum of 1000 rupees at the retail end. Only then they will be able to make some money. That's because of the waste what is being indicated here. Technology from mass to batch, batch to FMS. FMS is nothing but flexible management systems. So we need to wholeheartedly adopt technology and move from mass to batch and batch to flexible management systems where we are able to meet every expectations of the customer. That's important. That's the only way to reduce the unwanted things what I have listed here. Next slide, please. I said, you know, as we spoke about efficiency and effectiveness, something related to that is continuous and continual. All improvements are a result of simplification. You see, deliverables, layout, process, procedures. We have just a KISS. KISS is nothing but keep it simple and straight. KISS, K-I-S-S, which I'm sure all of you will love, because that's one way to convey love and affection from parents to peers to obviously kin and kids. So just keep it simple and straight. That's what the management principle is all about. Continuous and continual. Continuous improvement is the work of R&D institutions. The one mistake what as professionals what we make is we always look at continuous improvement. If you look at only continuous improvement rather than continual, you will end up only designing products and not commercializing it. Obviously, every development, every research has to have a staggered growth. The staggering is required to enjoy the commercial benefits of the improvement. So you please understand to differentiate the words continuous and continual. You can Google and find out what the difference is. Continual is a word that's been incorporated by Japanese. I am a strong believer of Japanese principles, and I have to make a submission here that I follow strongly the Japanese principles like 5S, quality circle, and obviously the continual improvements. Emergence of self-managed workforce. If you look at the kind of education level what people are going through today, anybody you see on the road, the next person you meet could be easily a graduate or a graduate or at least a diploma holder. Having said this, so these are the people who are going to come into the workforce. So the levels called the supervisor, superintendent, assistant managers is not going to be in existence in 10 years from the now. It's going to be department heads, and subsequently it will be only the people who are able to contribute and produce things. So the levels in between will be eliminated in the due course because of the education level and skill level what we are looking at from the people coming into the organization. Having said that, there will be more self-managed. Quite naturally, the way that you manage things will be completely different from where you have been managing so far. So this is very important. You should allow the bandwidth people for people to understand and perform themselves rather than telling them what they should do. And we, as a facilitator, we should look at growth. See, the amount of time what we spend on DRs, the daily routine management, as managers is going to reduce drastically because of the self-managed workforce. Next slide, please. Advantage India, amongst the youngest economy, this many a times we have spoken about it, but the challenge will remain, what do we do with this youngest economy? Can we get everybody employed? Can we get everybody buy our products and services? So that all depends on the affordability, and we should make people affordable. That's the biggest responsibility of educated professionals like us. Indians significantly everywhere. Thanks to software industry, today you know people are everywhere in the world. And there is a study which says that 22 decades from now, most of the senior positions across the world, irrespective of whether it's US, UK, or Europe, or African countries, you will only see significantly Indians heading many of the processes, at least not the organizations. Low cost of real estate and labor. Even today, thanks to dollar being 50 rupees, 75 rupees, our costs are comparatively lower than that of the many in the world. Quite naturally, the kind of capability what we have, this cost can be leveraged for the benefits. Now, today, if you have read yesterday's the Morgan Stanley chief speech, he has said very clearly, internal growth is what is going to drive the nations, and there's something called deglobalization that is happening. We have grown in an era where it's called liberalization, privatization, and globalization, LPG era, whereas the reverse is going to happen now thanks to the pandemic. Technical manpower and language skills. Easily, we are able to speak English, which is the recognized business language of the world. And people normally say whoever can master the mother tongue can also master English. Obviously, it is only by practice. Somebody who is good in thinking in their own mother tongue, naturally, if they can't start thinking in English, the speaking skills will also emerge. Growth of SMEs. SMEs is normally considered the drivers and backbone of any economy. Small and medium enterprises. You can imagine living in a city like Coimbatore, the role of SMEs cannot be undermined at all. They have contributed very significantly to the exchequer of not only development of Coimbatore, but development of the state as well. Today, Coimbatore industries have gained the recognition of both our Prime Minister and the Finance Minister as one of the best industrial hubs for the growth to happen. That is why Coimbatore is chosen for bringing in the Defence Innovation Hub. The culture. For any economy to grow, there has to be three capital: social capital, cultural capital, and knowledge capital. Social capital and knowledge capital is a derivative of cultural capital. Thanks to our upbringing, especially our respect for parents, our respect for elders, respect for teachers, our culture is much better than many of the cultures elsewhere in the world. It is our duty to preserve this culture and leverage this culture for the growth of not only ourselves but as a nation as a whole. There is a huge gap between consumer expectation and provider readiness. So unless we adopt technology, we will not be able to meet consumer expectations, and they will go in. anywhere they, where they can get at least some satisfaction from the products and services they buy. Next slide, please. Some of the tools, modern tools, of course, they have been in existence for many years now, but just to recapitulate, probably as newcomers, you will enjoy what I'm saying. Just-in-time and Kanban, they are all again Japanese principles. Quality circle is again a Japanese principle. TQM and TPM, total quality management and total preventive maintenance is again a Japanese principle. Six Sigma is an American principle. Lead management is again an American principle. And agile structure is again an American principle. All the six principles, seven principles what I have highlighted here is completely focused on growth and profitability. Some of them like Six Sigma, lean management and agile structure is focused on growth, whereas JIT, Kanban, quality circle, DQM and TPM help you to achieve the profitability the way you want to achieve. Balanced, appropriate use of technology. As I said in the beginning, it's not technology for the sake of technology. Next slide, please. The scenario, as I said in the beginning, thanks to the disruptions what we are going through, I'm sure disruptions will always be the order of the day. So the best way to overcome disruptions is to create disruptions ourselves. So obviously it is going to be increasing complexity, world, unprecedented changes, unpredictable technologies, an uncertain environment, non-availability of relevant data. Whatever the quality of infrastructure what we have, especially the IT infrastructure, that is not sufficient for us to understand the market changes. So quite naturally, what we are looking at here is bringing in some kind of a flexibility in the way we manage things and be prepared for the changes that are going to be happening in an unpredictable way and unexpected way. Compromise between risk and returns and modernization. So look at the kind of the farmer's agitation what we are going through. It's a compromise between risk and returns and modernization. Farmers are not willing to take the risk what the government is trying to sell to them. Quite naturally, because of the kind of the moderate expectations of the farmers today, the kind of agitation what we are seeing is no surprise to us. This is what naturally happens in any organizations what we go through. The way we are brought, the unlearning does not happen with the speed with which it should happen. Quite naturally, we have biases and we don't accept change so easily. If you're not ready to change as a student, it's going to be very difficult for you to come into the organization and be prepared for a change. Next slide, please. Changes in management, as you see in the left column, what it was in the last decade, what is going to be the future. The skills have given way to knowledge. The product-centric has given way to learner-centric. Graduation has given to lifelong learning. Learning should not stop at all. The cost of competitive advantage, what we are looking, cost is just not sufficient for being competitive. You have the participation across here, it is bad, active participation. Look at the way the education is happening now, the web-based education. You need to have active participation rather than passive participation. Just in case here, just in time, see world of difference. Static content, here it has to be customized content. Whereas mandated here is self, as I said, earlier, we used to tell the people what they should do. Here, henceforth, it's going to be self-directed. Instructor-led courses here, it's going to be library of learning methods. So your professors are going to become mere facilitators than the teachers. And that's what postgraduate education is all about. It's all self-learning. So unless you're committed to learn yourself, you can only take a horse to the pond, you can't make it drink. That's what happens to a student when he is not committed to learning. Next slide, please. As a closing remark, what I would say... Hello.
Hello.
You're able to hear me, ma'am?
Yes, sir.
I think the slide gone. Okay. As a closing remark, I have quoted here our Prime Minister Modi. Don't get me wrong, it's only the statement what I liked here. No way you're trying to promote the present government or BJP as such. The century is going to be linked with the virtual world. Maybe in the days to come, we will have virtual Mars and digital manufacturing. Change is coming fast and we need our urban areas to keep pace with these changes. Fantastic words, I would say. It sums up what the management all about. It's going to be digital management, it's going to be virtual management, and it's going to be self-regulated management. Nobody is going to be there to monitor you. The one of the most erudite scholars said, your behavior is what, you are, the character is reflected in the way you behave and nobody is noticing. That is what it sums up. Remote working is going to be the order of the day. Shared cost and infrastructure is again going to be the order of the day. Self-managed workforce, home-to-home monitoring, employee mix, cash flow precedences, traditional, towards zero debt, traditional employee, the older style of management where everybody was living in a colony. Focus on automation, obviously, optimized fixed cost to variable cost ratio. It's all about 5 M's. Again, I'm repeating, man, machine, materials, methods, and money. So far, whatever we have heard, it's going to result in managing this 5 M's in a better way and the most suitable way to deliver products and services what the customers may want. Next slide, please.
Yes, sir.
The critical is the success depends on the teamwork. Obviously, 1 plus 1 should be 11 and not 2 or 3. That's very important. You should start working as a team right from home onwards. Your family is a team. And if you can manage your family well as a team, you will be able to manage the organization well as a team. Measurables and controls. Everything what we talk about should be objectively measured. There should not be subjectivity at all. If you can't measure something, you will not be able to control. The capability to deliver extraordinary performance with ordinary people. 5 fingers are not same. Obviously, the kind of people whom we get into the organizations are not going to be same. You're going to manage people with higher education or lower education. Now, how do we deliver performance with these diverse people? That's where the management is all about. Next slide, please. The future of management is going to be multidisciplinary, multi-mode, multimedia, and multi-partner enterprise. It's just not we alone. As professionals, you will agree we cannot live in isolation. Obviously, as long as we cannot live in isolation, we cannot build an organization which can thrive on isolation. It's going to be 100% completely focused on market and market expectations. Next slide, please. Friends, a statement by Toyota chairman, Toyota style is not to create results by working hard. It is a system that says there is no limit to people creativity. People don't go to Toyota to work, they go there to think. Thinking possibilities, that is what the new generation managers are all about. Business should not outgrow population. There is a possible link to it, but not greed. Recognize it. Predictive management, believe people will be what they want and what when they want, and don't overestimate. Leverage IoT, move to virtual from actual. Benefits for outright costs. Never wait for government to bring in fiscal interventions. We need to know what we are supposed to get and what we will not get, more importantly. Redesign often to stay relevant. The organization, as I said, agile organization is the order of the day. Thanks for the wonderful opportunity given. I'm sure this session would have added at least some value to budding professionals and the teachers as well. Wish you all the best and have a wonderful future. My prayers to the Almighty to bless every one of you with the great future ahead. Thank you so much.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. Really, it was a very enlightening session, and our students are much blessed today. That you have given a caution that the future is going to be how we have to think in a broader sense. Update ourselves. Now I invite our professor and CEO, Dr. C. Gunasekaran sir, to address the gathering and
the students. Can I cut off, doctor, if you permit me?
Yes, sir.
Please. Thank you and wish you all the best.
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much for your blessings.
Yeah, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you. Bye.
Thank you, sir.
Can I start?
Please, yeah. Sir. Please.
Good morning, everybody. It's a great opportunity for me to speak to you in the morning today, especially the newcomers of the institute. First of all, I would like to congratulate them for having taken an excellent decision in their life to choose their profession. Congratulations to the new students who are joining today. the decision what you have taken in your profession is to become managers. As the chief guest has told, the future is very uncertain. There are a lot of ambiguities, and you are going to encounter a lot of uncertainties in your profession, with so much of complex situations which is going to arise in your managerial career as an expert managers. So the greatest opportunity now for you, the number two choice, the number one choice is the profession, and number two choice is the institute. I'll be very happy and proud to announce that you have taken one of the best institutes, which is taken an objective, a goal to produce the best managers for facing such kind of uncertainties in your career, for facing such kind of complexities in the career, and then to come out in a dazzling colors. So the two choices which you have made today, one is the profession and another one is the institute. Profession, if you compare the managerial profession, there are so many professions available, like you can be a medical professional, an engineering professional, an accounts professional, or anything like that. But I can just share an experience when I was talking to one chairman of a leading company based at Mumbai. He was checking up with me about his son's higher studies after his basic degree. I advised him to, he was checking up with me whether good institutes are available in Coimbatore. I said, yes, there are a lot of world-class institutes are available in Coimbatore where they can give excellent education. He is running an engineering industry. So I was thinking that he will put his son in an engineering field, engineering course. I told him there are good institutes with more than 50-year, 60-year-old engineering institutes are available. But he said that he doesn't want to put him in an engineering institute. I was surprised. I asked, you are running an engineering industry. He said, I can employ as much engineers as possible. I can employ as much other professionals as possible. I want my son to become a manager. So he should know how to manage the industry. So he has sent him, he has sent him to one of the leading institutes abroad. And then he became an economist, studied economy. And he became a manager of the complete managing director of the industry now. And he is performing extremely well. So that way, you being managers, you have a lot of opportunity to control the complete organization and keep the complete organization under your control. In very soon, maybe after a couple of years of your education in WIMS, you will be transformed into very good and efficient managers to face any kind of challenges. Not only in profession, like the chief guest has mentioned, the management studies is not exclusively for your profession only. It is also to make you a good human being. So you will know how to manage your relationship with your peers, how to manage your relationship with your family members, like your parents, spouse, and things like that. So that way you will become a very good human being. And we are also not teaching you the education for your profession, but we are the WIMS is giving you a beautiful experience and education for your life. So that way, I congratulate all of you once again for having chosen the profession, management profession, and for having chosen a great institute, WIMS, so that you are assured of your bright career and in your profession and in your personal life also. I once again congratulate all of you, and then wish all of you for a very best life, and enjoy your studies for next couple of years. And my office is open anytime. You can drop in and then look for any kind of support, help, and cooperation. I hope I all our faculty, teaching and non-teaching staff also are all waiting for giving the best support to you, so that you will all be transformed into a very good human being, as well as an excellent and efficient professional. Thank you for the opportunity given. Thank you once again. Thank you one and all.
Speech and your blessings to all of us. Now I request our associate professor Dr. Uma Maheshwari to deliver what of
Good morning to one and all present here. With the best quote, I start my vote of thanks. Gratitude makes a sense of your past, bring the peace for tomorrow, and create a vision for tomorrow. From this quote, I possess the vote of thanks. I thank my management, secretary, CEO, and director ma'am to giving me the opportunity. I thank our guest of the day, Mr. Nityanandam Devaraj, executive director, my allies of chairman of Sri Avinash Shepherd Trust, who despite his busy schedule has found time to grace this occasion. Thank you, sir. I thank our chairman, Mr. Perisamy sir, who encourages us in all our ways. I thank our secretary, Mr. Saravanan, who motivate us each and every activities. Thank you, sir. I thank our CEO, Gunashekaran sir, who joined hands with us to provide the valuable contribution and guidance for each and every activities of the day we are going for. Thank you, sir. I thank our dynamic director, Dr. Valarmathi ma'am, who is the backbone of all our success, each and everything what we are going for. Thank you, ma'am. I thank my colleagues and non-teaching staffs for this effortless contribution who works behind our screen. Thank you for everyone. The occasion will not fulfill if I'm not thanking this person. Yeah, I thank my students, the wonderful budding managers and entrepreneurs who are going to be in future. Thank you everyone to make this occasion as a grand success. Once again, I thank you all for present here. Thank you, and all the best for the students those who joined today. And in our institution, what our CEO has said, as you have been addition, what you have taken is an excellent decision, and we have been there to guide us in all your ways. Thank you, ma. Thank you.
Thank you. Dear students, thank you so much for joining this inaugural function. Your class first years, your class will start on tomorrow. We will send you all the timetables, what you need, all the facilities, what are the things you want, we will send to you. Please get in touch with your tutor. Your tutor is Dr. Uma Maheshwari. She will guide you over each and everything. Thank you so much.
Thank you, ma'am.